In this video, I'm going to show you how to use the Animation Snapshot action and Animation Preview feature in Storyboard Suite 4.2. The Snapshot action lets users record animations with greater detail, and the Animation Preview can be used to quickly preview an animation without needing to run the entire application. These features can save a lot of time when creating and refining rich animations. So let's take a closer look at Storyboard to see how this is done. So I've started working on a fitness tracker application. It's going to start up with a photo as a splash screen and then fade out to show the home screen. From there, I want to have an animation that's going to move the menu into place. Let's take a quick look at how this is going to come together. I'll simulate the app and we can see it starts off with a photo and then fades out. And now in the home screen, the plan is to have the menu buttons slide into the empty space on the left. The reason the empty space is there is because there's an action when the application starts that hides the buttons behind the home screen button at the top of the screen. So let's start off by creating that animation that brings the menu onto screen. I'm going to take the menu buttons and align them with the top of the home screen button. Now they're hiding behind the home button. Other than that, I'll fade in the button for adding activities. So I'm going to press the record animation icon, and for the first animation step, I'm going to take the cycling button and drop it down on the y-axis from 55 to 243. After moving it down, I'm going to click on the animation snapshot icon, and what this is going to do is save that specific movement as the very first step of this animation. So for the next step, I want to take the cycling button again and move it up the screen by 20 pixels, so now it's going to feel like it takes a little bounce. The idea is a button drops down, and when it bounces, a new button drops down until the menu is fully shown. So while the cycling button comes up, I want the next button in the menu to slide down, which is the running button, from 55Y to 187. Then I'll use the animation snapshot action to mark where the running button is going to bounce, and now I'm ready to slide it up 20 pixels and move on to the walking button. The walking button drops down, I'll grab its position with the snapshot action and move it up 20 pixels. So now, the last part of the animation is to fade in the activities button. So I'm changing the alpha on the activities button from 0 to 255, and now I can stop recording the animation. And I'll give it a name and call it Show Menu. If we take a look at the animation timeline, we can see the animation that we just created. With the snapshot action, instead of having four animation steps that all happen at the same time, we have seven animation steps that occur in a sequence they were designed for. The cycling button drops down, then the running and walking buttons, and after that, the activity button fades in. To get a better idea of how this is going to show, I can use the animation preview feature. When I click the icon to preview the animation, a window appears and runs through the animation. If I want to watch it again, I can reset the animation, play it again, and I can even pause the playback. Use the scrub to move back and forth through the animation. These features help users to visualize their animation, make edits, and instantly preview and refine their work. For this animation, I'm going to shorten how long it takes for the buttons to bounce. So I'll select the second animation step for each button and change its duration to be half. I'm also going to change the rate from linear to easing out. So as buttons approach where they're going to stop, they're going to slow down when they ease out. For the first step of the buttons, I want them to ease in, so they're going to speed up as they slide down the screen. And since they're moving further when they come down, I'm going to increase their duration a little more. Let's change it to 625 milliseconds. Now that's taken care of, I'll make the bounce for the buttons flush with a drop. Other than that, I'm going to change the fade in for the activities button so that it happens sooner, and I'll make it gradually appear. So let's change that to be 1200. So now I'll give it another look in the preview, and I like how the buttons come down and bounce, and the easing in and ease out looks good, but I think there's too much of a delay between one button to the next. So I'm going to go back into the timeline, and instead of having the second button start at 500 milliseconds, I'll speed it up and have it start at 150, and the third can start at 300. For the fade, I'm also going to move that to start at 150. And now I'll take the bounces and snug them up with the drops. And we'll take a quick look in the preview. And it looks good to me. So let's try it out in the runtime. So first things first, I need a trigger to start the animation, so at the application level, I'm going to add an action. The trigger event that I'm going to use is the animation complete for the splash fade animation. So when that fade is done, it's going to trigger an action, which will be our new animation, and we called that show menu. So now that I've got that in place, we're ready to take a look. So I'll launch a simulator and save the changes that have been made. And now our start screen appears. We fade to the home screen and our menu animates onto the screen and looks good. Let's take another look. Fades out, menu drops down, and it shows well. So that's the animation snapshot action in Animation Preview. It's easy to work with, users can record animations with greater detail, and testing works quickly with the Animation Preview. To learn more about Storyboard Suite, head to cranksoftware.com. Thanks for watching.